Here's a very nice short fragment that we unconsciously choose the way we think. And thinking isn't a conscious process. Our attitude molds our thought forms. A thought itself is it's a magnetism. It's magnetic, the realm of thought. A positive thought, let's call it a positive thought, a high frequency thought, a thought of connection, of a loving thought. It draws loving thought forms. Thoughts have their own reality on their own plane, their dimension. They cluster together. Can't see them, of course. We can't measure them. They're much too refined for any instrumentation humanity yet has. But how could they not be? They're electromagnetic impulses. So they have attraction and repulsion. And our attitude molds the thought forms around us. So let's say you have a really strong set of opinions. Then those opinions simply draw those thought forms around them like a cloak, and they kind of create a shield so that your mind can't be open, can't be flexible, can't be bendy. It's not able to mold and adapt to higher thought forms. You're just in that helmet, It's just stuck in your brain. But thought is actually is huge, it's vast. Thought has to have love inside it. Then it's not just stuck in your head. We always talk about people being stuck in their head. Thought can transcend. Thought can connect and open up people, pathways, relationships, creativity. So in that sense, thought is like the world weather. And it attract it, it's a pressure. A high pressure system pushes all the clouds away. A high frequency system pushes the clouds away. Whereas a low pressure system, which is putting pressure on yourself inwardly, it attracts the clouds. So a clear mind repels confusion. And a clear mind repels doubt. And so the mind takes what's in the heart, what's in the soul, and it works with that together. So really watch your thinking, watch it and just see how it's working. See how certain thought patterns are drawing to you other thought patterns, and then they cluster around you and they close you down. And then out of that gets created, experiences. Whereas when you open them, you open your mind and you have loving thoughts, then your aura opens up, the clouds go away, and you start to feel clarity, you start to feel the heart open, you start to feel breath moving into your body, spirit. And then there's this clarity, this lucidity that comes into you. And your mind is no longer something trapped in this local area. It starts to travel into the possibilities of the cosmos. It starts to become truly creative, truly full of potential to do anything, to merge with the boundless, with the infinite. So we need to keep our minds young in that way, not by adding more thoughts, but by sifting. So, when you're reading something or you're listening to the latest theory by someone or you're watching an interview or you're watching a film or whatever, we have to sift all that information. And things that close us down, we let them go. We just don't, we don't attract them. We don't draw them in. It's like If you've got a load of people in a room arguing, you don't engage with those arguments. You listen, you watch, and then maybe at some point you can inject a higher thought, more open thought that breaks that chain, that pattern, that then keep, that frees out those emotions that were blocked by those thoughts. So emotions rest upon our thinking. They rely upon the way we think. This is how we're programmed and reprogrammed through our childhood. The emotions are an older part of us, but the mind, once we clear the thinking in the mind, then we begin to open up the field of the emotions and we feel better. We feel joyous again. We feel that clarity. So think about the thought weather that you are creating in your life on a daily basis and how that's programming you, your life, the people around you. Think about that and see what different kind of thoughts you can attract. Just change the magnetism. This is what contemplation is. You contemplate something numinous, something higher, something beautiful. You listen and take in thoughts that are of a higher nature. And then the weather clears, the sun comes out inside you. And you share that, and it's infectious to others. Open-mindedness, open-heartedness.